shards of the light strewn behind you. Records scratch, these lines will break the tone of time till their meaning will find you. Say it doesn't matter now. Angel is nothing standing in your way. Did I forget to mention how I'm done with you? It's not my problem.
I'm going to sing a brand new song. I'm on TV too. Wow. It's really high tech here. This is called Blood from a Stone. Tracing some familiar fault line, running down the coast from you to me. Dark potential just beneath the surface. All the worlds colliding in the tragedy. Yeah. Has become our only currency. You pay me and I'll be sure to pay you back. But step quickly till you've crossed the jagged border. Cause the earth may shift beneath you. Pull the rug out, all your history, keeping track. Blood from a stone. In the face of your distress, aches and pains all shall put aside. I'll turn to my conclusions, but I'll leap to your defense. And I wish I were the brave one as I breathe another lie. Cause it runs in the family, courses through our veins. And gets caught in our hearts. a family. It's a little like insane. The things and the trappings of the artist in the art.
Thank you. So I would like to dedicate this next song to my mother-in-law. Oh, that must be her. It's been 8 years of pretty much hell. She's French, and that should probably explain most of it. But no, there's more. we recently played in Paris for 6 nights straight, and my mother-in-law came every night, sat front and center, and was like gesturing wildly through the whole set every night, like, you know, recognize me, introduce me, stand me up for the audience. So I obliged. But there were some moments when she would do really obnoxious things in the middle of ballads, like, you know, fix your hair. Fix your hair, you slut. No, and this was, of course, the subtext, which I understand very clearly. She hates me because I stole her son. I'm not Catholic, and I'm American, and I don't eat pigeon. And so this has sort of been a problem. So I'd like to dedicate this song to her. It's called Inconsolable. Sort of how she makes me feel. Her name's Janine. But more on France later. Until I'd had more than my share, I let the darkness in, and it was there and I lost the dare. It was then I lost the day. There will be no prayers on your return, and there will be no party thrown, and you will find your inheritance is the silence that's grown. It is the sea. Cause you were the one sure thing. One sure thing. Maybe I'm not crazy.
inconsolable.
Duke Levine. Wow. Any questions? That was in You Can Do No Wrong tuning. Frying, you're all musicians. I know you're scaring the pants out of me. G, sort of like D, whatever the next one normally is, B, D, B, G, D, G, C, on the bottom. Thanks for asking.
Okay. Scary.
This song is, wow, called West Point.
Die here.
So we were playing in Boise, Idaho recently. No, it was a solo gig. For some reason, I was on this blues festival with four men. I can't hold the guitar at the same time. So I was sort of the representative chick singer, I think. And so what the weirdest thing was that these blues festival people are just avid dancers. They'll dance to anything. So I went first. It was Taj Mahal, Robert Cray, John Hammond, Duke Robillard. I mean, like a serious lineup, and me. And I went first, and it was still daylight, but they were dancing fools. And I thought I'd show you a few of the steps that I picked up while I was there. Dancing to ballads, to, you know, the most sad moments. It was just really entertaining, I should say. So it started out very, like, you know, just sort of waif-like. And then it turned into this, like, huge modern dance, like. To ballads. So I started ranking them. This was during the Olympics. The Olympics were still on. So I just thought, you know, I made a joke. Like, okay, 6.2, 7.3. I'm sorry, you're disqualified. Your bootlace wasn't tied. And they got all pissy with me. They were like, I don't think so. I'm a 10. So that was Boise. Thank you. I think they're going into West Side Story. Ingrid got her toes done today.
All 12 of them.
And now we will attempt to imitate horns. Badly. I'll speak for myself.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Please.
Your desk might catch on
Thank you.
borders between conscience and faith. Lord, get my room ready. Nothing is adding up. We'll meet the terrible angel straddling our pitiful fathers. Meanwhile, I'm gonna sleep all day, get half drunk each night. Be the nothing that is, I'll be the nothing that will be. I'm gonna sleep all day, get half drunk each night. Be the nothing that is, I'll be the nothing that will be. All day, each night. All day, each night. Meanwhile, I'm gonna sleep all day, get half drunk each night. Be the nothing that is, I'll be the nothing that will be.
Thank you so much.
Hope us out. together.
Virgilio on everything. And this is Ingrid Groudens. This song is called Deny. It's also brand new, but why not? This was inspired by a screenplay that I don't even know if I got the gig, but I was so moved by the script that I wrote this song anyway. And it's a story about a young man who has AIDS, who has been basically estranged from his family, and he goes home to die, basically. And the whole script, it's called In the Gloaming, and the script is sort of about him trying to reestablish a dialogue with his parents before he goes, and so this is called Deny. You cannot deny.
You can deny me now. Oh, my Lord, why is it taking you so give me grace and the dignity to right these wrongs. I will lead today. I will follow you tomorrow. On the gloaming of my life brings the promise of a peaceful night. Just one thing that I need to know, so you will not deny. You will not deny me now.
Thank you. Did you try the chicken? It's really good. That's what we had. This song is called The Angel in the House. The original Angel in the House is this four-volume book of really bad poems written by a guy around the, I guess around the turn of the century, Coventry Patmore. And it's all about ideal femininity, long-sufferingness, silence, purity, godliness. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with all of that, but it was just a little constrictive, I think. You know, for modern day. Virginia Woolf got a hold of this manuscript and sort of turned the angel in the house into this notion, this phantom that we are trying to kill. This sort of antiquated version of who we're supposed to be, especially when it keeps us from our work. So this is about that. All of us girls trying to make a living. Especially my mother and grandmother. I think in another time, my grandmother would have been just the best piano player in the world. But she couldn't really get out of the house.
Send it really. keep us cold again and again. Never collected her $200. Landed on the purple with the Jones. She wanted to be a different person. She sat down finally.
Thank you. I think I inhaled a fly. I gotta cut out the cigars, I guess. My friend Laura thinks this next song is called Stilt Boy. She actually gets all the words wrong. She thought Over Oceans was called Ovulations. She wrote me this letter, Jonatha, oh my God, I can't believe someone finally wrote about it. Ovulating, like, what a great idea. So, Stilt Boy is called actually really At the Still Point. But I think it's just much better as Stilt Boy. What a cool image, like. think it's the air conditioning. I inhaled. Are you guys all cold enough? Oh, a lozenge would be good. I'd probably choke on it. I should probably... Maybe later. So this is At the Still Point, or Stilt Boy.
By your side, 2 years in the forest, can't see the trees if you hide. If you forgot, could I make you remember the piece of yourself that you gave long ago? It's on the top current of love's final breeze. There are the still poor. To the world, but at the end of indifference. We'd be the lovers that time could forget. Distance would forge us, make us stronger in the end. You'll make me remember the piece of myself that I left winding by. It's on the top current of love's final breeze. There are the still points around me. The still point, the still point, the still point.
That's Nick DiVirgilio. Nick, what else do you do, Nick?
Huh?
I mean, drums, bass. Oh, he plays trumpet, too. Did you hate that? What else?
Harmonica.
Piano. What else? Come on. Cough it up. Harmonica?
I fake play all these things. I really don't play
into it. Oh, he fake plays. You're right. I'm gonna sing this song now. It's about my dogs. Thank you. My one dog, Lola, we had to get rid of her. I think her parents were brother and sister. So she's no longer in the family, but Rex, my main dog, still around. He had a really big summer. I don't know if you all have dogs that kill things, but Rex is a killer. Great with small children, but he basically polished off a whole family of groundhogs this summer, and it was pretty traumatic for the family, my family. I went away for a gig one day, too, and this was actually the story of the very last groundhog. I went away for a gig, and I had my neighbor take care of Rex. So it was a Sunday, and Ann took Rex to the PARK and took him for a walk, and it was a beautiful sunny day, and young families and small children. And Rex took off for about 20 minutes. He comes back with fresh kill. Ann gets all scared. She thinks, oh, he's going to have the taste of the wild, and he's going to attack me if I try and take his prize away. So she lets him keep it. Rex puts him back on the leash, continues the walk. Sunday afternoon, 3 o'clock, young families with children running and screaming, getting out of her path. Takes him back to my backyard, leaves him there with the groundhog. So I get home the next day and there's really nothing left except for the front paws. So all this to say, Rex is a really great dog, and dreams a lot at night about his adventures. So this is about his dreams. It's called Dog Dreams. Anything to add? Did I forget anything? Nope. Great. Duke? Okay, feel free to sing along.
Me and Rex took the car stay home. Stay. We're gonna run over all the neighborhood. Cause they tease us from the other side of the fence. We're gonna go in the swamp and you can't hose us off. Dog dreams, dog dreams. No dry food, no sit, lie down, roll over, shake.
took the car. Stay home. Stay. We're gonna go through everyone's garbage, have the dinners we deserve.
We're gonna find some great smelling bitches.
Finish with this one. Thank you so much for coming. I had no idea you would be here. Thank you. Wow. So I'm speechless. Thanks. Tom Strait is doing sound for us. Again, this is Duke Levine, Nick DiVirgilio, Ingrid Groudens.
I cannot find you.
you've got my hands, and you've got your father's eyes. Lovely old eyes. I know that it's not fair. Things aren't always what they seem. Now I worry so. Where you'll lay your head, where you'll sleep tonight away.
Thanks so much. There's a lighter back there. Oh my God.
Well, that's a good idea. Well, we'll do this one first. I mean. I think we have to, like, hurry up, though, because there's another show. Yeah. Okay, we'll do this, and then we'll do Gilda Cage.
Thank you.
it's mine to carry on now, cause I will always disappoint you. Is it vengeance or your pride? Do you lose me like that? Hang it on your bracelet. Charming. Charming. In a dream it's all a test that I face by myself. Lose a briefcase, I lie at the airport, swallow the inky code. Well, I'll answer in the end in a temporary time. But for now, don't say anything. Don't say anything.
Shoot, I already said we'd do this one. This one's almost, you know, the same. It's called The Gilded Cage. was my sort of rebellion song against my upbringing. I rebelled really late. I was 28 when I finally knocked everything off its pedestal. It's a little late, don't you think? Blissfully unaware all through high school that things were sort of screwy. Thank you so much again for being here. Thank you.
Virgilio, Ingrid Groudens, thank you so much.